What's up, cyberpunks?
I'm Jesse.
And I'm Sebastian. And we are here from the Digital Acid. And a robot is going to make us some burgers. How about that?
A robot? Where is this robot? Let's take a look. Some important work is happening at the
creator. It's a robotic burger shop.
It's kind of like Willy Wonka's Chocolate Factory, only they're making burgers instead. I mean, this stuff is amazing.
I mean, it's like grinding the cheese, it's slicing, it's dicing, it's toasting the bread, it's cooking the meat exactly the way you want to have it, and it's completely without human hands.
Right, but it's also responsible. It's sustainable, local, grass-fed beef, cooked to perfection.
Perfect.
The price is good, they've got good beers.
$6 burgers.
I mean, so listen, we've covered the robotic security guard. Check. We've covered the robotic coffee shop, Cafe X. Trash.
Man.
This is the real deal.
This is
not fake robotics that just moves a cup from here to here. It's actually doing the physical labor.
Yeah, they've got Top Chef, literally Top Chef 2015 creating a burger here. They've got the guy from Bar Tartine, world-renowned bread maker, taste maker, literally making these burgers for us.
What did you order?
I had ordered the aficionado. It's got an amazing list of ingredients, which I can't remember off the top of my head right now. I'm really looking forward to it. It's smoky. It's got all the right stuff that I love. So
I've got the creator versus the world. Look at that name.
This is like the beginning of something huge, you guys. So I'm excited to taste this burger. I don't know about you.
Yeah, we're gonna give you our thoughts, and also in the meantime, what do you guys think about all this? This is insane. Leave your comment below.
Look at this delicious burger that this robot has prepared for us. Mmm, tasty. Looks so good. The bun looks great.
Fries are crispy.
On point. I can't wait to jump into this. But I mean, this is like, this doesn't look like a McDonald's burger or anything. This looks like pretty efficient.
Really nice brioche bun. We got the aficionado.
Boom.
It's got mustard and ketchup and barbecue sauce in it.
All right, so on three, we're gonna take a first bite.
All right, get ready for it.
Probably get ketchup all over this shirt. Ready?
All right.
One, two, three. Part of a good burger. Well, there you have it. A delicious burger. We'll check in after, but I just wanted to give you the first impression. Check out this ketchup that's running down my face. And yeah, man, this is a good robotic burger. I would say it's the best robotic burger I've ever had.
For $6, this is the best burger in the city. I mean, that's like unstoppable. The flavors in this, it's not a $6 burger. Grass-fed beef, my favorite. Wow. All right. All right, guys, you gotta get over here. Try the robot burger. It's a feature. If you are what you eat, then you must be a creator.
Ah, boom, there it is.
So that was an amazing burger. Just finished it.
Delicious.
So good. I had the, as I said before, the aficionado, but now I have the menu in front of me. So that was a smoky, sophisticated flavor one, and that it was, let me tell you.
That's right. And I had, the creator versus the world, and it's kind of an interesting metaphor. What do you guys think about that? Is it really a creator versus the world? Do you guys think this is a good idea to implement robots to make our food? I mean, it tastes good. Good enough, right?
It tastes great. I mean, it was designed by humans in the image of humans as a creator,
right,
as the creator would do.
Right. And actually, something else that's on the rise, which is a similar parallel, I've read about these robotic arms in which they can record world-class chefs putting together recipes, and then basically they can record these sessions, and then these robotic hands can
recreate these recipes from scratch, like mixing the batter in the bowl,
everything,
you know, like flipping burgers on the grill. Two robotic arms like basically record 3D motion.
So, right. I mean, and to the sub-millimeter accuracy of how that human would rotate its arm.
But of course, you would need an AI to figure out the operations, you know, like size of buns or whatever, tomatoes different size, that type of thing.
So I think this is the first step in that direction. And so, you know, maybe one day we'll have robotic kitchens in the future. But what do you think? This is a good idea? It's a bad idea?
So replacing jobs? I mean, this place employs like 15, 20 people. I mean, you can see them in there. There's a lot of people working there. So it could be creating jobs. I mean, there's still a spot for service.
Right.
And it's maybe freeing up other jobs. Like maybe we should switch from the scarcity model of thinking to the abundance theory model, where everything is provided for us by robots, and we now can do what we want. I mean, right now there's a transition.
Right, and I think this is like, you know, beta testing, if you will, and maybe that's why they have the humans, but perhaps we may see Creator in the future go fully autonomous. That could happen.
I see it happening. I mean, probably not right away, but you know, maybe 5 years from now, maybe 15 years from now, but this is a great beginning. I mean, they're doing it right. Grass-fed beef, sustainable, great flavors, getting expert, top chefs to come in. I mean,
locally sourced, all that. And so, like, then it also, you know, what other things could we employ robots to do outside of burgers in a similar parallel?
You know? Everything. I mean, just, you know, Elon Musk said it.
Right.
We can do everything.
Everything.
Better.
Everything better than us.
So, anyway, so that's our review of Creator Robotic Burgers. Make sure to tune in for more. If you're not already subscribed,
please do. We need subscribers. We need your help.
We're here always reviewing the future. So robotics, AI, AR, VR, intelligence amplification.
Intelligence amplification.
And you name it, we're on it. So, and that's it, man. So I'm Sebastian from Digital Acid.
Jesse right here.
Woo woo. And we'll see you next time.
Subscribe.